Hello, I'm Rien Simon, and in this tutorial I would like to show you how you can personalize your RouteYou Premium account. This is done via your My RouteYou homepage, which you can access via the main menu. We click on this button to access that main menu. On top of the main menu you will find the account you are logged in with. So this is my premium account, and next to my account name there's an arrow which you can click. If you click this, then a list appears with some direct links which could be interesting to you. The first one brings you to your My RouteYou homepage or landing page. So I click on it. So this is My RouteYou landing page. So this is my personal page on the RouteYou platform. For now, this is quite empty and standard. So I can add my logo and I can add links. I can add some branding if I want. And I will show you how. So to do this, to adjust this, you can go to your profile page, which is accessible via this pencil. Click the pencil, then you click profile. So this is my profile page, and the first subject is the public data, and that is what we need for this. So you click the public data. Here you can see which account you have. So this is a premium account. Then you can see the language in which you are accessing your account or in which you will add information. So you start with your mother tongue or the basic language you want to give some information about yourself. Afterwards you can add other languages if you want. So this is where you insert your account name, and here you can add a description of who you are, or who your organization is, or your club is, and what you are about. Do this because if people access your page, they will want to know, and make it original and informative, so that they are intrigued and maybe are intrigued to access your personal page or social media pages. So after your description, you will find some more visual items to adjust your account with. So let's start with the logo. If I click this, I can insert a logo. So let's say this is my company logo. Then you will see there are some buttons next to this field with which you can adjust your logo to make it a perfect fit. This is quite alright, so I don't have to adjust it. Next to your logo you have the avatar. A lot of people insert a photo here, but you can also, for example, choose to show an element of your logo. Let's say I will do that in this case. So I add my logo again, and then again, for example, zoom in a bit and then move this item and say let's okay. This is my logo, and this item of my logo thus will be my avatar and represent me on the platform. You can add a link to your logo, which means if people click on your logo, they will go directly to that page. For today, I will pretend that I'm discovering Belgium, which is a very interesting party that has quite some beautiful routes to offer on our platform. So make sure you have a look at their account. So I'll add the link here. Then afterwards you can adjust the header background, so that's the big picture that is on top of your page. So you can choose what you want to show here, and you can use it to make it more representable. So again, I will choose a picture. So I'm about tourist information and interesting routes. So I choose a picture that says just that. Now you can see this is the box. This is a representation of the header. If I add this photo there, and this way there will be a lot of white space next to the photo, which isn't beautiful. So let's zoom in a bit to make sure that this picture is a perfect fit to the header bar. So let's say this is how I want to visualize it. After the logo and the header and stuff like that, you have promo logo and promo banner. This is also a specific functionality for a premium account or higher. With this, you can add a specific logo. For example, if you make a separate logo for an event, or you can make a banner of the sponsors you have for your event, and you can add them here. If you add a promo logo or a promo banner, they will be inserted to your print, your overview print. So you can use that print for the event. So, but that's a different tutorial. Let's move on. And then here you can see there's a lot of options to add social media links. Let's have a look. Apparently, Discovering Belgium is very active on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram. So I will now just copy those links into the correct bar. Then let's take Twitter and then Pinterest. Voila, maybe the created shouldn't be there. And then the Instagram, let's add it as well. You can also add your YouTube channel if you want, or your LinkedIn your LinkedIn page or your Flickr page, whatever you want. We made it accessible here. Then let's confirm and wait a minute. So he's now saving my modifications. Et voilà. Here you can see that now my personal my RouteYou homepage is personalized. I can see my logo here. If I click on it, I will directly access the website page I added here. The same as can be said for the social media buttons that are added now to your page. So via this way, I can, for example, directly make a connection to my Instagram page. So this is interesting because if people access our platform and search for a route, for example, find a route, let's say a walking route, voila, and the vicinity of Brugge, which is where we are stationed. Zoom in a bit. Then you can see all the results popping up, but here you can find the different organizations or persons who have their avatar mentioned here. So our route should pop up here as well. For example, Door de Hens Binnenstad is a route I made. It's in Dutch, but that's not really important for the moment. So now here you can see if I click or another person clicks on this route, my branding is inserted here as well. So you find my logo, you find the link to my social media accounts. People can click on this and then they will enter my website. Or if they want to know who's the author behind the route, they can click here. And then again, they will enter my RouteYou home page I have. If you would like to add information in different languages, then you can do it via your profile page or via a direct access. Again, you go to the pencil and then add a translation. And then this will take you back to your profile page. And then in the public data section, you can add information in other languages. Voilà, thank you.